Shall we begin?
Let's begin now.
It's Wow Factor!
Let's begin now.
On today's show, Alex Mathis. Musical guests, Marshall Jefferson and Colin McGuire. And Paige Chilson. And I'm Montgomery Brown. And here's your host, Colin Noah Griffin, sitting the other dude.
I'm really coming after that.
Dude, well, you were making scratching noises the whole time.
So you guys call me Colin?
Is that your middle name?
No.
What's your middle name?
Wade.
Wade. Wade sitting!
It's still Griffin. I don't go by my middle name.
Oh.
What does it smell like up here?
Well, on today's show, I'm really excited because I am hosting this section called Fear Factor. Have you heard of it?
Yeah.
Okay, well, this is the Wow Factor, Fear Factor.
So the wow
you are going to be heads up. You're going to do a competition of eating gross stuff.
Eating things that smell like this?
Well, I will reveal them in a bit. But first of all, let's bring out our contestant, Paige Chilson. Thank you, everyone. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Hey, Paige.
Hello.
All right. This is your competitor.
This?
Paige. Yeah, she has volunteered.
She?
From our studio audience. Hey, studio audience.
There's so many people.
There's so many. All right. So, Fear Factor, where we eat disgusting things. But first,
is that what these are for? I saw these earlier when I was.
Oh yeah, these are. Are you team Army or?
I'm Army.
You're Army. She's Zebra.
Oh boy.
Apparently, you can put them as do rags or something like that.
A do rag?
I don't think do rags would be. Maybe a bib.
While you're doing
what are we
that,
eating?
Just don't cover your mic.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
But first, what are you most afraid of?
Me?
First page. Here.
I am most afraid of boat propellers.
Boat propellers.
I am deathly afraid of boat propellers.
How often do
we don't have that on the show?
Boat propellers.
Not very often, but.
What causes fear?
I read an article when I was probably too young to be reading an article about a woman who got her leg caught in a boat propeller.
Well, that is very unfortunate. Do you know anyone personally?
No.
Okay. All right, well, what about you, Griffin?
I'm scared of horses.
Horses? Our producer says we had that later on today. You can hear them.
The producer's gonna get fired.
You're terrified of horses. Why are you terrified of horses?
I don't think they're safe. I think they're
very large, wild animals.
Right, and their teeth are gross. Like, gross. And their feet are disgusting.
Why are these reasons you must hate, like...
Because, like, if those teeth were to come anywhere near me...
Because he has gross feet and teeth.
I don't know him, though, and he probably doesn't neigh.
Well, anyway, to our challenge, our first challenge, is an eating competition.
I think we have to be blindfolded.
Are y'all blindfolded? Are they by producer?
Yeah, let's blindfold you.
Okay.
So,
let's just jump right into it. Do y'all want to be blindfolded?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right.
Let's try this.
All right, we're revealing our two ingredients.
Wait,
here.
Blindfold her.
No, we're not blindfolded.
Yes, that's more fun.
Let's do it.
Okay, fine, let's blindfold.
I think my head's too big.
All right, you blinded?
Yeah.
Okay, well, the audience will see this.
How many fingers?
Ingredients. They won't.
What?
But she doesn't see. How can you eat?
I can't see.
I'll lift it up.
Okay. Let's get on with this. All right. Ready, audiences members? All right, first one. Gummy worms.
Oh. Why would you tell us?
And our second one.
I don't want to know. Don't yell at me, because I know what it smells
pickles.
Like.
Pickles!
Ew.
Oh, the napkins are wet. All right, here are the rules. First person to put all the gummy worms in their mouth and say, look, Mom, I'm on the Wow Factor. Spit them out and then eat three pickles.
Excuse me? We have to do the gummy worms and the pickles.
Put the gummy worms in your mouth, spit them out, and then Either, hey, there's no cheating here. There's no cheating. Oh.
Well, that's supposed to be
anyway, so let's get started. All right, you have the plate in front of you here. This is your gummy worms.
Okay.
Here's your gummy worms.
I can do gummy worms.
All right. Are you ready?
Yep.
Are you mark? Set, go!
Okay.
All of them?
I think this might be a big challenge. Oh, look at Griffin go. He's got, oh. Mm-hmm. No, say what? Say it. Look, my mom's laughing. Oh, dude, oh. Are you okay over there? Oh, oh.
All right, let me eat my pickles.
All right, all right. Oh, are you sure? Is that a taste of
pickle?
Alright,
alright,
alright. Oh, you're going
to be
so gross. Alright, alright, here are your pickles, okay.
Oh my gosh, I hate pickles. Wait, do I have to eat these?
Yes.
Am I eating them?
Yes, yes, eat them, eat them. Quickly, Griffin's on down to his last one. He is down to his last one. Can he go all the way? Finish him!
Woo!
Oh, he is done.
Sorry about it.
He is done. You remove your blindfold.
Ew.
Hey, give everyone a round. Look give at our winner, Griffin. Pickle.
Your hands.
Oh, your pickle.
I really don't like pickles.
Thank you. All right, we have our next challenge.
While I
up.
Clean up the studio from my mess that I've made, we're gonna take a quick commercial break. And then we'll be back with more Wow Factor. But Paige, thank you for being here. We'll see you in a little bit.
Thank you.
When I came to High Point University, I was definitely not planning on majoring in history, but after I took my first history class here, I really changed my mind and decided, you know, I can't really understand the present until I understand the past.
We lived with the reality that we could be nuked. So for most of us, this is something that we grew up with, or it came upon us at some point.
This is caused by cosmic radiation.
That's one of the reasons why I think understanding the Cold War is so crucial, because it helps you understand this frame that we've put upon our relationship with the Middle East today.
One of the great things about our department is that for a school our size, we have a broad offering of courses that deal with time periods and also different places around the world.
At High Point University, every student receives an extraordinary education in an inspiring environment with caring people.
Well, I still have the taste of pickle in my mouth.
It smells like pickles.
I don't like it, so.
Just wait for the next ingredient. It's even more fun.
I don't want to know what that is. I mean, I do know what that is, but I'm gonna act like I don't. So while I go find some mouthwash, a toothbrush, and a jar of tomato juice, we're gonna take a quick look at the Friday video that some students at school have produced.
I'm looking forward to this.
And after that, we have Alex Mathis joining us for a quick interview.
I know Mathis.
So we'll be back with more Wow Factor after this.
Wake up in the morning, gotta be Friday, gotta go to the cafe. Do I want pizza or maybe stir fry? Watching everybody running to class, passing the pool, girls all around. Gotta get down to the trolley stop, gotta catch a trolley. I see my friends going to the village, one or maybe number two. Maybe catch the townhomes or Uville in the afternoon. It's High Point, High Point, purple and black at High Point. We have everything we'd ever want here. High Point, High Point, everything's free at High Point. From the ice cream truck to the cinema in the UC. Partying, 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 partying. Fun, 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 looking forward to basketball season. 5:45, we're driving through campus. cruising so fast, gotta get to the steakhouse. Yum, yum, think about the food. You know what it is.
What?
I got this, you got this, my friend is by my right. Hey, on the dream big chairs, wasting time away. Kicking in the hammocks, laying next to Gandhi. Sitting up by Atlas, riding a giant panther. High Point, High Point, Needle's the king of High Point. Everybody's looking forward to sleeping, sleeping. High Point, High Point, they build way too much at High Point. Everybody's looking forward to the Greek village. Parties and parties,
woo!
Parties and parties. Fun, 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 fun. Looking forward to more free ice cream. Freshman year there was Finch. Then I lived in Blessing, building dorms each year. And every year we're gonna have a new one today. Junior year there was UC, and the village came afterwards. I don't want the buildings to end.
NQ, Nita Quibane. Still playing in the arcade,
in the
UC. I'm driving NASCAR, fast lane, switching lanes with a friend up on my side. Passing by is ice cream in front of me, makes move, 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 move. Wanna scream, check my time. It's Friday, it's a weekend, we gonna have fun. Come on,
it's
y'all.
High Point, High Point, gotta love it here at High Point. Everybody's looking forward to the concerts. High Point, High Point, getting down at High Point. Everybody's looking forward to the weekend. Partying, 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 partying. Fun, 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 fun. Extraordinary every weekend. High Point, High Point, I don't want to leave High Point. Everybody's looking forward to graduation. High Point, High Point, the best school in the South. Everybody loves it in High Point, High Point. Partying, 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 partying. Fun, 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 fun. Enjoy all that's here at High Point. Yo, we got shout outs to AK in the studio working on this.
Holla.
Got the hammer right here, joined by the 30-something Brero. You hitting us up right now, 336-841-9000. You heard?
Let's be dancing. High Point.
That was good, right?
Yeah, I think that has more hits than actual Friday now.
I don't know.
I think it does.
I bet it could. Okay. All right, so will you help me welcome our guest?
Oh, yes. Our new guest.
Yes, new guest. That would be right.
Alex Mathis, come on down, sir. All right. How are you, sir? Good to see you again.
How's it going, Alex?
Nice to meet you.
So, Connected. What's it about?
Oh, it's about Dave Price.
Dave Price.
A college sophomore who gets lost in the world of his video game called Run Amok that he's very addicted to playing. He's kind of lost in all kinds of technology, cell phone, music, computer games, of course, movies, and it overwhelms him to a point that...
He is very connected.
Extremely connected.
Hence the name Connected. Yeah. So your character is?
Dave Price.
Dave, okay. And how's filming going? Because you guys are still filming, right?
Yeah, we got one more weekend left. Like he was just saying before, it does take up our weekends, but
12 hours Saturday and Sunday.
So 24-hour weekends.
Yes.
Pretty much. It's a lot of work, but it's still fun. You know, it's the kind of work where you'll enjoy to do it if you love what you're doing.
Right.
But other than that, yeah. Even though I've lost my weekends, it's a great experience because I've never done anything with film before.
Right.
And I've learned quite a lot. Like, it's very, very pragmatic. There's just, you show up, you do this, you do this, you do this. It's like, it's a whole schedule. And Goodman, I've learned he's very strict on what he wants to get done.
Yeah.
So.
So since you said you've never done anything with film, that was my next question is, what's your major?
My major is performance theater.
Oh, okay. So you do theater.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And Montgomery is the...
I'm the director of photography.
Director of photography.
Yes. I run the Red Camera.
Oh, that was the big deal about this movie.
This is a very big deal. The same camera used to shoot such movies as The Social Network or District 9 and, let's see, Book of Eli. Those are, so the same camera used, it's around $90,000 when you put it all together. Wow. So I'm in charge of that equipment.
I dare you to break it.
I almost did. This past shoot that we were working at this dark warehouse.
Yeah.
We were using the Steadicam, and the bolt bent on this arm that we use.
Right.
Oh yeah.
And yeah, that was surprising.
So you guys film all over.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've done. The first day was here.
Second
day was at the bakery. Then there was a weekend at the warehouse. There was like a warehouse that we filmed like the majority of all the shooting scenes.
We use firearms with blanks.
Right. So I think we actually have a few pictures to show from shoots from Connected.
That was from the first day.
That's the first day. There you are. You're pretending to type on your laptop.
First, I don't. Did they take any pictures during the actual filming of it? Because I don't know if they were allowed to do that.
Yeah, they're supposed to.
They're supposed to do that. Okay.
Well, actually, not during.
Pictures during film. Yeah.
But because I think the flash, I think the camera makes noise. There's
where is this from?
That's from this the latest weekend.
He has a battle scar.
Yeah. It just kept getting bigger with the makeup. They had to keep, because in between takes, they'd keep having to put more makeup on to keep it looking, you know, fresh.
Right.
And it would just keep getting bigger.
Right.
because in the movie, he got shot like 4 minutes ago, but that was like, in the shot, it was like two.
He got shot in the cheek, or is it just like a battle wound?
It was like a graze. And I was supposed to also get kind of a more serious graze on the arm.
Right.
But, I mean, the makeup looked pretty real to me. So.
I think we have a few more pictures. Yeah?
That's
you can see me behind the camera. And there's, yeah, that's weird. Yeah. And there's Goodman, our director and professor, who is guiding us through that.
So that was the shot where the light just kept getting it was a cloud. Unpredictable.
Yeah, it was a really patchy day weather-wise, so yeah, like, it was bright, patchy. And it was dark, and so it was...
And I think we have one more.
Yeah.
That's Anthony on camera. That's the arm I was talking about.
Oh, okay.
That's the Steadicam that broke. That's the camera stripped down.
Where is that? Where is that being...
That from? Is outside one of the warehouses that the university owns.
Right. Yeah, that was like 5 minutes away.
Oh, really?
That one was...
Okay. Well, I really appreciate you coming in. I had no clue what Connected was other than...
The film will be out next semester.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I guess I'll have to come back since I won't be here. But...
You'll hear about it.
I will. We're going to take a commercial break. And then when we come back, I think I have to eat something else, apparently.
Dun, dun, dun! Yes. Yes, you do.
But thank you once again for coming.
Thank you guys.
And we'll be back with more Wow Factor.
Today in class, we went over specific exercises such as the handstand push-up, where we talked about the actions of the shoulder girdle, the shoulder joint, the elbow, the wrist, and the specific muscles with that exercise. Since I am on the track team and doing schoolwork at the same time, I have to learn time management skills and be able to go with both doing homework, but also being able to go to track meets and practices.
In exercise science, there are basically two main things we look at, and that is exercise for health risk modification in the general population, as well as exercise and training for superior sport performance.
Exercise science is a really interesting major. It kind of lends itself to a lot of different fields. You can do pretty much anything you want with it when you graduate that's in the health field.
At High Point University, every student receives an extraordinary education in an inspiring environment with caring people.
We are back with more Wow Factor, and I am in the Jungle Man mode.
All right.
Arrgh. Oh, I mean, I don't know what Jungle Men say. But we're going to watch what happens when tornadoes hit High Point University. And then when we come back, I have another challenge.
in my house right now, and there's a freaking tornado warning. It started as a severe thunderstorm warning. It's for all the counties around it. It was 6 miles away, and now it's coming this way, and I don't know what to do. This tornado is going to piss me off. I was in my bed, I was sleeping, and then boom! Here it comes, wind, the rain, it's all coming, the trees are blowing down, the lights are flickering, everything's just happening. I can't see anything, I can't see anything! Oh, the blinds are closed. I didn't even get to say goodbye to my mom. Puppy. My poor dog! I let him out! I let him out just 20 minutes ago and now... Air Bud!
Wrong movie.
I just got that puppy. I really is my family and I just want to go back to New York. I don't know what to do. This tornado is going to kill me and I'm going to die at the young age of 19.
Do I look more jungly now?
You do.
Let's get our competitor back up here.
All right, catch a little wimp.
The little wimp back on stage. Woo. So, right. I've been eyeballing these.
Oh, yes. Just, all right, for our next.
Alex is joining us in this challenge.
Alex is joining us. He is bravely volunteered, voluntold.
I got my game day bib on.
All right, and this next challenge in Fear Factor, Wow Factor. Wow Factor, Fear Factor. We have Peeps. Each contestant must put all 12 peeps in their mouth and say, look, I'm on Wow Factor.
There's 12.
No the. If you say the, you are disqualified. There's no the in Wow Factor. Okay. Any questions?
Is there any illegalities to this?
Don't cheat this time.
I
didn't cheat last time. That was just a fabrication of your imagination. Figment of your imagination.
Here are your peeps.
These are mine? Okay.
These are yours. All right.
Are you ready? Because I'm ready.
In the box still.
Well, yeah, put all peeps down, please. All peeps down.
You broke them.
Give this to him. Keep your peeps down. Okay.
Go. Let's go.
All right. Sit. Go. And they're off. Oh, he's doing four at a time. Alex is doing two. Who is gonna win? She's doing one at a time. Oh, their mouths are getting fuller. Don't laugh. Laughing is gonna just mess you up. I think this is just clearly impossible, like the last one. But they're gonna do it anyway. There are sprinkles flying everywhere as they breathe in and out of their mouths. Oh, what was that?
I said I'm on Wow Factor.
I didn't hear you. Well, we know who has the biggest mouth.
That's me.
Are you okay, Paige?
There's sprinkles all over me.
You sprinkles everywhere. Yellow.
All right. While they keep choking and not winning, we're gonna.
Oh my god.
Our musical guests, Marshall Jefferson and Colin McGuire.
All right. Woo.
so sunny recently, I don't know what to do. Cause in my heart all I see is dark clouds and you. And if you don't care, then I just don't know what to do. Sometimes in this life you gotta make a choice. Sometimes in this life you gotta do your own thing. Sometimes in this life, yes, you've gotta let God take you. Sometimes in this life you gotta say, I don't care. It's been so cloudy recently, I don't know what to do. Cause in my heart all I see is sunny skies and myself and you. But if you don't care, then I don't know what to do. Sometimes in this life you gotta do your own thing. Sometimes in this life you got to tell yourself. Sometimes in this life you gotta make your own way. And sometimes in this life you gotta say, hey.
Well, two, thanks.
What's up?
It's been a wonderful show.
It was.
We don't have time for your final thought today.
But we'll have it next week.
And we will be back for one final glorious
wow factor.
Good night. Good night. Or bye.
Something.
Goodbye? Au revoir.
Adios,
amigos.